everyone. Today, I wanted to show you how you could upgrade your memory on an iMac. And I'm gonna show you how to do it on a 2017 27-inch iMac, but the process has been the same for many years. The 2012 iMac, for example, was the previous Mac that was sitting here. The process was the same. So if your Mac is newer than 2012, this should be the right video for you. And I wanna take you through how to buy the right memory, how to find out how much memory your computer could actually handle, the max amount, and where to find that. And then I'll show you the physical install, which is really easy. You'll save a lot of money than if you get it done through Apple. If it's your first time here, I post tech tutorials just like this one 5 times a week, so consider subscribing. Now let's jump into the computer so I could show you how to find out how much memory you have, how much memory your computer could handle, and where to find the best memory for the price. So on your iMac, click the Apple icon and go to About This Mac, and then go to the Memory tab in the middle of the page, and you should see how much RAM you have. So in this case, I have the base 2017 model, 8 GB of RAM, and they're divided into 4 GB memory sticks. So I have 2 4-gig memory sticks that add up to 8 GB. And what's important to note here is you have to install the memory in pairs. So if you install a 4 GB, you have to install another 4 GB in pair of twos. You don't have to do all four the same, but I can't just do 1 8-gig and 1 16-gig, for example. I'm gonna buy 2 16-gig sticks. That'll combine to be 32 gigs. You have to install them in pairs. Also, there is a max amount you could have depending on the age of your computer. In this case, it's 64 gigs, but let me show you how to find that. Just click this right here and go ahead and select the Mac that you have. In this case, I have the Retina 5K 27-inch 2017, and it's gonna show me how much max memory my computer can handle, 64 gig in this case. So if I wanted to, I gotta get 4 16-gig sticks. So I would have to remove the 4 GB sticks and install 4 16-gig sticks. But in this case, I'm just gonna install 2 16-gig sticks. That'll be 32 gigs plus the 8 I already have. Okay, now if you've already bought your memory, you could skip ahead and find the process of installing the RAM. But if you're looking to find the memory, this is the website I use, macsales.com. I'll have a link in the description. And you wanna go to memory, go to iMac. And now you could select the iMac that you're looking for. So make sure you match the right iMac. In this case, I have the 27-inch Retina 5K. So I click this one and it's gonna give me some of the options that I have for my memory sticks. 32 gig, 16 gig sticks, two of those. This is what I'm looking to do. This is actually almost half the price of what Apple charges you if you get this out of the box. So this is a really great way to save money. So if you wanted to go full out and get 64, you'll have to remove the RAM that you already have. I'm just gonna save the ones that came with it. I'm gonna get these 32. I already have 8, so that's gonna give me 40. So I'm gonna go ahead and add this to the cart. So in this case, you have 4 slots. So this is the best option if you wanna go and max out your iMac. 64 gig kit, 16 gigabytes times 4. So now let me show you the installation process. It's really straightforward and really you don't need any special tools to get this done. So choose a surface and lay down a blanket because we have to lay the iMac down, and go ahead and power off the iMac, unplug it and lay it down on the surface. So the memory sticks are in this little compartment, but there is no way to get to this compartment unless you remove the power cable. And now you should see this little switch here. If you press the switch down, it pops up that compartment, and this is how you get to the memory sticks. It was a little hard to do this with my finger, so I just used the pen to press this down far enough. With my finger, I couldn't get it down far enough, so with a pen it was really easy, and then I used my other hand to pop up that compartment and remove the cap. And to get access to the memory, you just gotta push these two apart, and it basically brings up that tray, and you simply have to pull on any of these memory sticks to pull them up, and you could install them the same way. You should see 4 trays here. My computer came with the 4 gig sticks. There's 2 of them. I'm gonna install the 16 gigs in between. You should see the holes in between the 2 that are already there. These are the 2 memory sticks that came in the mail from macsales.com. So I'm gonna take these out of the package and install them. So now to install them, the 2 that I already have in there, I'm not gonna touch those, but there's a slot in between the 2, so I'm gonna insert my memory stick right there into that slot. And then there's one slot on top. I'm going to stick that one right there. If you're installing four, so if you're going max to 64 gigs and you have four sticks to install, you have to remove the two because they have to be installed in pairs. So remember that. Just don't install one memory at a time. And now I could just push it back in gently and I could put the cap back on. And that's all I have to do to replace the memory. So now let me turn on the computer and show you what happened. So again, I'm going to click the Apple icon, go to About This Mac, and then go to the Memory tab. And as you could see, the two new memory sticks showed up. So now I have two new 16 gig sticks, and that gets me the combined memory of 40 gigabytes installed. Again, I could always upgrade later and take the 2.4 out of there and install 32 more gigs and get a total of 64 gigs. That's the max on this iMac. On an iMac Pro, for example, the max is 128 gigs. On the 2012 iMac, the max was 32 gigs. So make sure you find out your max and decide how much RAM you want on your computer. I hope you found this useful. Please give it a thumbs up and comment below with any questions. I post tech tutorials just like this one 5 times a week, and I try to simplify tech as much as I can. So please consider subscribing to this channel for a lot more videos just like this one. And as always, I hope to see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.